saw it on TV, actually. That's how it began for me. It was some show on TV with these old silversmiths from George Jensen, just talking about their work, you know, their craft. And then I just had to try it out myself.
I worked 2 years in the George Jensen flagship store, but after that, I finally got accepted as a silversmith apprentice. And that was a dream come true, like something sent from heaven.
My grandfather worked directly for George Jensen back in the 20s. My father was also a silversmith at George Jensen in the 50s. When I wanted to become a silversmith, my father wasn't so happy about it at first, but I insisted. I really insisted.
You start with a sheet of silver, and after more than 10,000 blows, you got a Henny Couple fish dish. And you do it all by yourself, just you and your hammer. It's extremely hard work, a very tough process, but I love it.
Over the next 2 years, I got to learn all these special techniques, all these very special techniques, which aren't used anywhere else in the world.
The fascinating thing about working with silver is you can mold it into any shape you want, just by hand and with a few basic tools. So if you have both the skills and the imagination as well, then there's no limit. There's just no limit. And you can spend a lifetime just exploring all the different possibilities.
One day, the King of Denmark stepped into the workshop. He wanted a cigar box made, and my grandfather got the job. He spent a lot of time on that cigar box, a lot of time and a lot of energy. When it was finished, the Queen of Denmark came to the workshop and thanked him personally. Now, 27 years later, I have also made things for the Royal Danish family. I have made a few gifts from the Queen to her husband.
I'm a silversmith now, but maybe someday I'll be a designer as well. Coming up with my own designs for George Jensen. Becoming a part of that tradition, that would really be an honor. A great, great honor. And yet another dream come true.